Heloise. This is RetroTK2 and welcome to this version control tutorial. Today we're collaborating with another dev using Gideus. Make sure you check out my other version control videos, Ace, as a lot of the concepts we'll discuss here have been explained in greater detail in them. So let's get started. Say we have another dev called Joe who wants to work on our project, Ace. Joe can clone the repository using the remotes path. Once cloned, Joe's repository will contain an exact copy of the files on the remote repo. Let's see what happens when we both make changes to the project, Ace. Here I'm adding two different files to each of the repositories. Stage the changes, commit the changes, and push the changes, Ace. Nothing new on Joe's side so far. Same on my side, Ace, stage and commit, but when we try to push the changes, I get an error. Since Joe has pushed his changes to the remote repository, we need to fetch his changes in order to add them to our repository. We then need to merge the changes with our master branch and push those changes to the remote repository. This may seem a bit tough to get your head around at first, Ace, but we'll take it slow. First, we need to get the changes from the remote repository and put them into our repo. Click the Fetch button in the top menu and click OK. Now we can see that our master branch is one commit ahead with my commit and one commit behind with Joe's commit. Now we need to merge Joe's changes into our branch. Click on the Pull button in the top menu, Ace. You should probably uncheck the box beside Commit Merge Changes immediately, as it gives you a chance to check the files manually before you commit them, Ace. I didn't do this for the first pull. Click OK. Since I didn't uncheck the box, SourceTree has automatically created a merge commit for me, Ace. Now both my changes and Joe's have been committed to my master branch. We're ready to push these changes to the remote, Ace. Click the push button and our remote will receive the changes. In the graph column, we can see a new fork in the master branch where Joe committed his changes. If I pull up both repositories, you'll see I have Joe's file in my project's root folder. Since Joe hasn't pulled my changes yet, the my change file isn't present in his project. This was an easy merge between two projects, Ace, since there was no conflicting files. Let's have a look at a merge with a conflicting file. Say I make a change to the added file and Joe also makes a similar change to the added file. Here I stage, commit and push first, Ace. Now Joe stages, commits and clicks the pull button. Since we're working with another dev, it's often safe to assume that a change has been added to the remote repo, Ace. The sequence stage, commit and push can be altered slightly to stage, commit, pull, merge if required and then push. With the pull request, Git will execute the fetch command as well, so there's no need to press the fetch button if you're planning to pull, Ace. Here I uncheck the commit merge changes immediately and click OK. Now we get an error when we pull, Ace. If we check our uncommitted changes, we see there's a warning icon beside added file, signifying a conflict with that file. There are a few ways to deal with this, Ace. Right click on the file and move to resolve conflicts. Here we can choose to resolve using mine or resolve using theirs. Since this is Joe's repository, mine refers to Joe's changes and theirs refers to my changes. Be careful with this, Ace, since mine won't always mean you. This becomes tricky when you're trying to merge two different branches, Ace, since mine and theirs could refer to two different branches that you have worked on, but we'll talk about that in a future video. Another option is to go into the file and manually change it. Since we're merging, both files have been merged into one, Ace. The line of text that says head is our most recent commit on the master branch, in this case, Joe's change. The two changes are then separated by the equals line and followed by the commit that caused the merge to fail. In this case, this is my change, Ace. The conflict ends with the commit's hash code. This will cause errors to show in your code, Ace, and you can navigate to each conflict in the file to resolve them. Here I'm removing the lines I don't want to commit, leaving me with the change I added. Save the file and close it, Ace. With our file changed, we need to tell Git that the conflict has been resolved. Right click on the conflicted file, navigate to resolve conflicts and click mark resolved. This will resolve the conflict and we can commit, Ace. Git will automatically fill in the commit message for you, Ace, with a description of the merge complete with the conflicts list. Feel free to remove this message and write your own, Ace, but personally I like to keep it. Click the commit button and push the changes to the remote. Okay, let's look at another merge option, Ace. Here I'm making another small change to the added file on both repositories and committing both. This time I'm pushing with Joe's repository first, Ace, and merging with mine. I commit the change, click the pull button in the top menu and receive the conflict error. I won't be editing the file directly, Ace. Instead, I'm going to use my version of the file and discard Joe's changes. Right-click on the conflicted file, navigate to Resolve Conflicts, and click Resolve using Mine. Since this is my repository, Ace, the Mine refers to me. By resolving the conflict this way, I've kept my changes to the file and lost Joe's. Ideally, you shouldn't have to do this on text files, Ace, since you can usually resolve them by editing them directly. This type of conflict solving is usually only reserved for complex files, ones that are difficult to merge, such as textures and models. These types of files really don't play well with Git, Ace, since Git stores a new copy of the file for each commit when the file is changed. With our conflicts resolved, we can commit and push, Ace. This is a brief look at what it's like to collaborate with another dev using Git, Ace. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe, Ace. I hope you're doing well. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with any problems you're having. Thank you for watching this, and I'll see you in the next video.